There are four main macromolecules in the body: carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, and nucleic acids. These first three will be discussed in other videos, but this video will focus on nucleic acids, specifically DNA and RNA. As you may have heard, DNA is the chemical blueprint for our body. Using just four different subunits in adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine, it codes for the over 100,000 different proteins in the body. To understand how this is done, let's take a look at a different coding system, the English alphabet. In the way that an old, fragile book might be housed in a library, DNA is kept locked up in the nuclei of cells. To prevent damage to such an old book, people read copies of it. Analogously, slightly different copies of DNA called RNA are formed and exported from the nucleus for reading. The book only contains the 26 letters of the English alphabet, and DNA only has the four subunits, or nitrogenous bases, described earlier. If we put letters together, we can form a word, but the word itself doesn't have meaning. It takes someone who speaks English to read the word and interpret it. In RNA, a set of three adjacent bases is called a codon. The codon itself doesn't have a meaning until a tRNA molecule reads it and matches it up with a protein subunit, or amino acid. Once we have words, we can put them together to make a functional sentence. In an analogous manner, adjacent codons make up a gene, and the corresponding amino acids are put together to make a protein. This protein then folds up and performs actions based on its reactivity. DNA and RNA even have start and stop codons on either side of a gene, the same way we use capital letters and punctuation to start and stop a sentence. But imagine if someone came in and changed, added, or erased a letter. Depending on the change, the sentence may still make perfect sense, some sense, or might be completely nonsensical. In the same way, a mutation in DNA can result in a protein that is either still functional, partially functional, or completely dysfunctional. If the protein is fairly unimportant, a mutation may not cause any disease. If the protein is vital, a mutation can cause a severe disease.